Hey everybody, Bryce Larson here. I'm doing the second half of the Check It Products V2 pump review that I said I would do, the after play test. I just want to kind of give you guys a real quick rundown. This gun, surprisingly or not to you guys, shot very much like this gun. Now, the reason for that is that they're, you know, basically the same gun. They're snipers, built their own pro stock bodies. The serial numbers, let's see here. They're only 17,000 apart. This is when they were cranking them out fast. This is just a little bit younger than this one, probably by a matter of, it could have been the same batch of manufacturing. This one got built into a Cochran and sold. This one didn't, you know, 3 years ago, 4 years ago, which means that Check It bought these guys and sent them out as pump guns, which is cool. I'm going to start this off by saying this gun shoots great. Pump stroke is extremely smooth, shoots nice. I did use the Sizer kit because this barrel will have rollouts. This is a slick little pickup. I've got guns sitting in front of me that are all going to be in that $200 range. Some are a little higher, some a little lower. I have all of them that are new on the market here, I think, except for the SL68-2, which I'll tell you why isn't a good deal at $180. It's because of this gun. Okay, so let's talk price real quick. This is a Check It 2, Check It V2. This is my one of my snipers. This is the Azodin Chaos pump. It looks blue in the video, or at least it does on my screen. It's not. It's black. It's just a powder-coated black. This is my Phantom. Let me jump over to the computer real quick here. All right, there. SL68-2. That's the other one. I don't have one of those because, well, I'll tell you about that in a second. All right, let's bounce. Azodin Chaos Pump. This is ANS gear. $149.95. Check It Products. Ooh, that looks familiar, huh? Yeah, pretty close. Check It Products. $179. This guy I bought used for $150, and we'll talk about that in a second. Yeah, Paintball Gateway will do the Vertical Stock Class Phantom for $259. That's with the 45 grip. You can get it for a little cheaper with the M16 grip. So we'll call that a $225 gun, something like that. So $180 with it in the package when you get it is an ASA that works fine, a reg that works fine, externally adjustable, very nice dual pump rod, no play on this pump kit. A stock barrel, which is fine, and a non-removable feed neck, which is also fine. Stock bolt, great. This guy I paid $150 for before the market became really tight for snipers. I got it with this grip frame, which is a single swing die, which is a pretty expensive grip frame. I got it with no ASA, no reg, no barrel, and this PMP Industries pump kit, which is like a $30 pump kit. All right, and a beat-up bolt. So I put a new bolt in it. I bought a Check It on-off, I put a reg, a headlane around it, and I put a barrel on it. Okay, so $150 for this one, no reg, no ASA, nice grip, okay body with a couple of scratches. $180 for this one, ready to go out of the box. I would recommend putting a new barrel on it, or at least getting their bore lock kit. Okay, Azodin Chaos Pump, $150. So this one is cheaper. This guy has a clamping feed neck, has a barrel, well, this is a Custom Products barrel because I took off the other one, three-rod pump kit, not something you can swap out. I put a reg on it. It doesn't need it. I put an CP on-off on it. Doesn't need it. It's got a decent ASA. Phantom. I'm going to put this in here because, hey, Phantom is in that price range, sort of. It's actually more. The Phantom is going to be another option in this range, and then the SL68-2. Of these, the best deal out here is going to be somewhere between the V2 and the Azodin Chaos Pump. These two guns right now are by far the best deals in the pump gun market. The reason that this guy and this guy are the best deals in the pump gun market is because they're ready to go out of the box. $180, $150. Either of these is going to be a really fun gun to play with. Now let me tell you how to choose between these. Technically, this is still my after play review of this. Pump stroke is extremely smooth on this guy. The gun is a little bit heavier, not a ton. It's got a double swing trigger. This guy also has a double swing trigger, so neither one wins there. Perfectly acceptable ASA. The one that comes with this, perfectly acceptable ASA. This guy has a slip fit feed neck. This guy has a clamping feed neck, a cheap clamping feed neck. This guy. The reason this might be your first choice is you can put a new grip frame on it. You can put new regs on it. You can put new rigs on any gun, but it'll take any rig. This pump kit is, there's no need to upgrade this. This is a rock solid pump kit. It doesn't have any clay on it. It's very smooth. This gun is already partially upgraded. I gotta say, this pump kit blows this pump kit out of the water as far as quality of build goes. This gun and this gun are basically built around the same bodies. Quite honestly, if I were to take these two guns and kind of merge them into one gun, you'd have a nice, nice high-end gun. This guy has a hard line on the bottom because I think it's cool. It's got a nice on-off. I got a nice, well, I have a free kit on here, which is great, so I can get my small bore action. If I took this free kit, this on-off, and this a little bit upgraded bolt and this grip frame and put it on here, then you have a legitimately high-end gun. This one base model is pretty much as good as this. Even though this one, new, not beat up, not from somebody else who put who knows what in it, new was $180. I spent $150 on this used, without a barrel, without a reg, without an ASA. So, deal-wise, and this was even before the prices went up. I think right now if you went out and tried to find this gun or something with this grip frame, this body set up like this, it's going to cost you a hell of a lot more than this, and it doesn't shoot any better. This gun, this Checkit V2, is going to be a phenomenal performance. I really like this gun. Now, the reason that all of these guns on the table beat the SL68-2 is that I don't like the SL68-2. It's a personal preference thing. It's cast aluminum. It feels, to me, the word I always use for it is unrefined. This gun, it's slick. It's got some shininess to it. It looks like there's some you know, there's some sheening that went on to make this happen. The SL68-2 is a workhorse. It shoots fine. It has an auto trigger. It's got a built-in gas through grip. It's not bad. The feed neck works, I guess, but this gun is way better for the same amount of money. And this gun you can take and do whatever the hell you want with. Got the you can put grip frames on here. You could get new triggers for it. You can get new regs that'll fit it fine. You can do the Eagle mod where you're gonna chop off part of the feed neck and put a clamping feed neck on there. It's got a ton of bolts available for it. This gun, it shot great on the field. I had a blast playing with it. This guy, you spend $30 if you want to, getting a new barrel, or you get one of these guys, or if you have an autococker threaded small bore barrel, which a lot of people do already, this gun is, it's done. I mean, you could upgrade it if you want, but there's certainly no need to do it. So, after play, I'll say, smooth pump stroke, great. Weight is exactly what I would expect from a pro stock autococker. Heavy? Yeah, but I don't really mind. You know, when I'm playing a scenario game, I slap a Revy on there and I put my 45-45 tank on it. The gun weighs some, but I don't really care. I mean, it's not like I'm a tiny girly man. I can pick up a gun that weighs 5 pounds, 6 pounds, 8 pounds. It doesn't really matter. Yeah, you know, end of the day, you might feel it in your shoulder if you're playing an 8-hour scenario, but you feel it everywhere at the end of an 8-hour scenario, so who cares, right? It's the weight is fine. There's a million upgrades you can put on it because, you know, it's a cocker. There's everybody out there making paintball parts for guns like 6 years ago made cocker parts. Everybody. There was nobody who didn't because everybody knew they bought a lot of parts. So cocker parts is great. Barrels are obviously super easy to come by because cocker is the barrel thread of everybody's choice now except smart parts. Yeah, so I'm going to say, you know, of these $200-ish guns, it's a fantastic deal. I don't think you can build a sniper that nice right now for $180. I really don't. If you could, I mean, you could go out and try. Totally worth it, but I just don't think you can beat the price. So anyway, that's my after play review. Smooth, shot great, weight is fine, performed exactly as well as I would expect a sniper to do.